I know who you are and I will find you. No, get out. Get out. Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lovers. Today's video is quite special. Today, we're gonna talk about your unpopular opinion. So I ask you on Instagram to give me your popular opinion about fragrances and I'm gonna react to it. And I found out we, most of the time, have the same unpopular opinions. A little disclaimer before the video started, it is not a negative video, it's really a positive way. So, you know, it's okay to criticize in a nice way, but it's not okay to use like bad words on when you criticize the fragrance. I think we all need to respect each other's opinion. You might not like a pineapple pizza, but someone else might really like it. So you're gonna say, I don't like pineapple pizza. You're not gonna say, this is trash. It's really not for that. We'll expect from you in the chat to be respectful and nice and in a positive way. It's, you know, it's funny to see that we have different opinion in fragrances and there's nothing bad against that. So I need to go back to my screenshot. So I tried to leave a little delay of 1 week and a half. Not remember what you said to me. I'm quite happy because you reacted a lot to this on Instagram. So there's a lot. So I'm not even sure I'm going to talk about everything. The name of Blurred, just because I don't want to encourage anyone to say, ooh, this person said this, blah, blah, blah. Okay, it starts really well. Aquatic fragrances smell like rotten egg on some skins. I'm confused. I don't know, like, I never experienced that. Maybe. I use all my fragrances all year round. Yeah, well, same to me as well. Of my winter scent, for example, I use most of them during the evening during summer. I'll be sad to leave one fragrance during like a month and month alone. Like, yeah, I agree with that. I absolutely can't stand the smell of Tom Ford Tuscan Leather. I know everyone loves it. Why? Why don't you like it? I don't think everyone likes it. Like, it's really like a quite powerful scent. So I will not be surprised that some people think like you. I absolutely love it personally. I think it's beautiful. I wish I could have wear that today, actually. I'm wearing 301 by Bon Parfum. It's really nice if you like cardamom. Love it. Adventures being not relevant. I don't think it's not relevant, personally. I think it's a bit overhyped. That's the only thing I'm gonna say. Le mâle fits more a granny in a church than a teenager in a club. Hashtag sorry. What? A granny in a church? No, no, no. You can say that fucking fabulous smell like a granny in a church. It can. But I personally don't think so. I think he's very sexy. But I heard that before because of the church. Le mal? Are we talking about the same? Those people think the same as well. The clubbing scent of the 90s, right? It's nice. Oh. That light blue by Dolce & Gabbana, I thought you meant, because I was like, G&G, who is this? And Daisy by Marc Jacobs are great fragrance. Yeah. Absolutely. I mean, I think for me, they are safe fragrance, but yeah, absolutely, they're nice. Like, I mean, I personally, the Marc Jacobs fragrance was one of the first scents I was really attracted to because of the bottle. I really like the design of the bottle, so I was attracted to them. Sometimes I think some are lacking of personality, but I think they are very safe, so I like them. I like Daisy. I think it's a safe option. Light blue as well. It's nice. But you know, I think popular designer always get their little haters. I'm being smashed for this opinion every single time. Oh la la. Oh la la la. Le mâle from Jean-Paul Gaultier is not always a good choice. It's a Sagan Le Mal. Oh my god. But I think again it's because it's very popular that it gets a lot of down and up critics. I usually hate those people that... Oh my god. This is your opinion, like he gives me like... It was too hard to read. Those people that go into a perfume shop and bath in a random expensive perfume. Oh, I don't like that at all. Like, I think it's very shallow. Like, some people just take... Oh, they will come and ask you what's the best one. I don't know what is the best one. It depends for everyone. Like, they're all really great. And... Why would you... Oh, what's the most expensive one? Why? Like, I mean, a Zara fragrance can smell better than one of a niche fragrance sometimes. So some people want to show off, so... Overly sweet gourmand fragrances are super overrated. Flower Bomb, La Vie est Belle, etc. Oh, I really like Flower Bomb. Really like Flower Bomb. But I agree that overly sweet and gourmand fragrance are... overrated. Started to go a bit because we in the trend of more aromatic, like it's going in a circle, you know. So I think it's going, so you might be happy. I don't like La Vie est Belle. I think as well it's really too sweet, and I would maybe prefer it if it was a bit toned down with something else. But like every time somebody's wearing it, I can really smell it around me, and I think it's a bit overpowering, understand? But after again, there's like people that only like gourmand and sweet fragrance, so you know, it's for everyone. But yeah, I think Carolina Herrera Good Girl design is beep ugly. Runs and hide. Yeah, go run and hide. I don't think it's ugly. That's not me. I don't wear heels like that anyway. Like I prefer to wear boots with heels. Like this is more me. So. Some clones are better than the original themselves. No. No, they can be nice, they can be really good, but they're good in another way. I mean, the perfumer have done it the best for him with his inspiration. So I don't think a clone coming with no inspiration can be better, because it doesn't know which is that inspiration. I don't know if you follow me on that. But for me, no, it can be a really good clone, really good. In its way, it's in its own thing. But no, it can't be better than an original. When you take 10 years of thinking of the inspiration and everything, the history, no. But I respect your opinion. But for me, no. Niche quality is not really a thing. Yeah, no. People make a confusion between niche quality and high quality fragrance. Niche doesn't mean high quality. Niche, it's independent perfumery, unique perfumery, things like that. It doesn't mean it's better quality, absolutely not. But that's a fact. It's not an opinion, that's a fact. Lovely by SGP, Sarah Jessica Parker, smells like a grandma. I love my grandma, but I can't like that scent. I understand you don't want to smell like your grandma. It's actually the smell of my best friend. And I always think she smells really good. Maybe your grandma has amazing taste, that's why. Jill Sanders, Sun. The least pleasant scent I have ever tried, and unfortunately blind bought. Don't blind buy. Don't! No, I never tried Jill Sanders. I'm wondering how it smells. Seeing the name, I would be attracted to a scent like that. So I kind of understand you blind bought it anyway. Who did try it? What does it smell like? Tell me in the comments. We can still be friends. Oh god. Oh my god. Chanel for men is massively overrated. Dull and average. Sorry? No, there's no sorry accepted for this. What? I know who you are, and I will find you.
I will look for you. I will find you. And I will...
I'm joking. Well, it's your opinion. But, I mean, do you think Egoist is dull? Because I want to know your opinion on Egoist. Do you think he's dull? I don't think so. How about Pour Monsieur? Dull? Sycomore? Or are you just talking about the men classic? I can, you know. Are you not wearing Hugo Boss, by the way? Oh my god, I'm stopping. Niche fragrances, contrary to the higher price tag, seems to become mass market product. Well, with the trend, that's really interesting actually, because with the trends in the fragrance community, for example, things like Oud for Greatness, like very trendy, or Baccarat, it looks like it. It looks like it. Maybe it's going to be reversed in 5 or 10 years. Niche will be the mass appealing fragrance. You never know. You never know. It's interesting though, very interesting. As a woman, I dislike when men wear anything more than a very light fragrance and prefer none. You prefer no. I'm losing my English. Really? Wow. Interesting. You like the male skin scent. I do understand. But I mean, for me, like if I'm dating, for example, someone that doesn't have any fragrance, it's like no. I mean, what are we gonna talk about? Aqua di Gio and La Nuit de l'Homme YSL. Exquisite smell, but very poor longevity. I think it's very according to your skin. Longevity is not, for me, a criteria of judging a fragrance. It is not. You can't judge a fragrance on longevity because it's too subjective. It's really too subjective. So Aqua di Gio is quite a light fragrance, so it's normal that it doesn't stay as long. La Nuit de l'Homme, for me, the classic, was staying really well. So, you know, it can be, in generality, people think it's poor longevity, but like it can really work on you for some reason. From your diet, your skin pH, acidity, we're talking about hormones, environment, moisturizing level. Please don't get upset, like if I'm saying something against your opinion. I respect all of your opinion. Like, I mean, it's okay. Creed fragrances are vastly overrated. Yes. That's why I wanted to try the house, buy some sample of the house, because I was thinking the same as you. And I actually really, really enjoy them. So I failed. Really, really nice. So it's a bit overrated, but in a way, it's nice. I think that Parfum de Marly perfume smell basic. Tom Ford or more niche smelling. Niche smelling. I prefer Tom Ford, 100%. I'm more Tom Ford lady, for sure. No. I think the same. I think they're more niche smelling in a way, more unique. Maybe more unique, that's what you mean. For me, 100%, yes. I like Parfum de Marly. Like, it's not mind-blowing for me. It's nice fragrance. For now. I need to discover it more. I think Dior Homme 2020 is good. Get out. You can only justify the price of fragrance with how long it will last on your skin. Absolutely not. No, absolutely not. Do you know, I'm going to give you a simple explanation to say something else. A natural fragrance, completely natural, using very exquisite materials, like jasmine from grass and things like that, only natural, will not stay as long as a completely synthetic perfume. Because natural don't stay as long as synthetic, so it will cost you much less to do a synthetic fragrance that lasts extremely longer on you, but doing a natural fragrance will cost you more but last less. So it's usually the good balance between the two. So no, there are fragrances made for only one gender. Dracar Noir, Miss Dior. Yeah, I agree, they feel like a bit more feminine in the way society tells us to do. I wore Dracar Noir, by the way. Niche houses sometimes try too hard to be different. Yeah, well, like when you think of Sombre, for example, that's different. Give me more. Tell me which houses are you thinking about. I love overspraying, but I live in an environment where everyone is super sensitive to strong smell. That's so sad. It's a bit like me as well. I really like to overspray. But I don't think my environment is that sensitive though, so I'm quite lucky. I don't like Baccarat Rouge. Well, I like it, but honestly, I think it's not the best of Francis Kurtjean. I much prefer Gentle Fluidity Gold. I much prefer Grand Soir. After a question of taste. Not everything has to be Beast Mode all the time. Yes, thank you. And I've got two words to give you an example. French perfumery. Patchouli is gross. Also, more men's fragrance should be floral. I agree, the second one, more men's fragrance should be floral. Patchouli is gross for you. You don't like it. I think that's what you mean. Dior Sauvage is overrated. Montblanc Explorer smells cheap. It doesn't smell that luxurious to me, but it's a pleasant smell to me. The biggest problem in the fragrance community is hype for mediocre fragrance. I want to know which one you're thinking of. Don't tell me Baccarat Rouge. Aventus, he's gonna say Aventus. Point. Patience with fragrances. Judging too quickly. Point. Are you talking to me in Morse?
The other side of the world is transmitted by Morse to the nearest provincial center.
Yeah. People judge too quickly. You need to try on skin. There's lots of tests to do. I agree. Not that big of a fan of Dior Sauvage. Lol. It's okay. And next to it, that Dior Sauvage is overrated. I love Laine de Verbe by Serge Lutens. 2.95 out of 5 on Fragrantica. You know, I really enjoy fragrances that got like bad rating as well. Like the last one I remember had a bad rating. Well, bad. No. It's okay. But not that good. It's Vanilla Vibe by Juliette Azagut. It's really nice. I think we're good, so I hope you enjoyed the video. It was really funny to read all your unpopular opinion. I think it reminds us all that we all have different opinions, and it's fine. You don't have to make a massive debate on that, like blah, 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 blah. It's not politics in here, it's fragrance. We share passion, and we're all passionate by it, and all have different opinions. If we all liked Picasso, that would be quite sad. I really enjoyed it. You guys been really funny, and I can't wait to make you participate as well. It's always nice to make you participate in the video. I feel we closer, so I really enjoy it. I'm waiting for, in the comments, your unpopular opinion. Please tell me what's yours, and yeah, like, join me on Instagram next time you might like to participate. I will maybe show the name next time, but yeah, please subscribe to my channel if you enjoyed the video and if you want to see more disaster coming in this channel, and yes, leave me a little like. I will see you very soon. Bye now.